A very good day to all of you. In the last class, you learnt about the file and edit menu. In today's class, you will learn about some parts of the view and insert menu. But before we begin today's class, let us revise what we have learnt in the previous class. Can you tell how to bring up a new slide? In order to bring up a new slide, you need to right click on the slide pane and then click on the new slide option there. A new slide will come up. Can you tell what happens with find and replace? With find, you can find a word in your paragraph, and with replace, you can replace it with a word of your choice. Can you tell what happens with duplicate? With duplicate, you can make many copies of a single image which will be exactly like the original. Do you know what happens with delete slide? You can delete any of your slides with delete slide. Now, all of you switch on your computers and open the Impress file using the method taught to you. If you come across a problem, then take the help of the video to open the Impress file. Watching this video, let us learn the shortcut method to open our Impress file. Look for the Windows button on the keyboard and keep it pressed with a finger of your left hand, and then press the R key on the keyboard. The run command box will open, and if there is something already written in it, you can use backspace to delete that, and then type S Impress without leaving any gaps. S-I-M-P-R-E-S-S, and press on OK. A box opens and you can just ensure that the empty presentation is selected because we want a blank presentation file to open, and click on create. So your Impress file opens with a blank slide. Come, let us now begin today's class. Have you been able to open your Impress file? If not, then watch the video again and open the Impress file. Let us see what you will learn in today's class. In today's class, you will learn about the options of the view menu like normal, outline, slide sorter, note page, sidebar, slide pane, toolbar, grid, header and footer, and about zoom. You will also get to learn about some of the options of the insert menu like slide, page numbers, fields, and hyperlink. Then you will also learn about font work gallery. First of all of you insert four blank slides in your file. Let us now learn about font work gallery. Can you tell what is the font work gallery? Font work gallery is a font design using which you can convert your written text to its style. By looking at the picture being shown, can you tell how you will make this font design? This design can be made with the help of the font work gallery. Let us now watch the video and learn more about using the font work gallery. With the help of this video, let us now learn how to use the font work gallery. So to use the font work gallery, let's first bring up a blank slide. As you can see in the video, a blank slide has been brought up on our Impress file. Now, in the bar below, you can select the font work gallery. Left click on it and it will open the font work gallery where many different types of font work are shown. So you can scroll up and down and select the one, the kind of style that you like. You can scroll up and scroll down to see other font works. So you will see different styles and font work is written in that style. Select the one which you like. By clicking on it and then click on OK button. Once you click on the OK button, this font work gets written on our slide and also a font work toolbar opens here on the left top side of our slide. If we want to make our text in this, we just need to select that and then we can click here as is being shown in the video. Once you click font work, the word font work is written in the center. You can delete that by pressing backspace and then type whatever text you want to write in this particular font work style. For instance, we are writing computer shiksha. Once you have written computer shiksha, take the cursor on the side and click there and you will see computer shiksha gets written in the font work style that you had chosen. Now if you select this again, you can now make any modifications to the boundary line, to the color of the boundary line, etc. So you can do the formatting. Here we are increasing the size of the boundary line. Now in the video we are changing the color of the boundary line by scrolling up and down after clicking on the drop down and selecting, for instance, the purple color. Again, for the fill in color, you can either select color as is shown here. From the drop down box, we have selected the magenta color. If you want to make other changes, you can select gradient option in the fill-in and select one of the gradient options available. Or you can, let's say, select bitmap in the fill-in color and select one of the options. So like this, you can make many changes on the text that you have written. You can change the color, you can change the width of the boundary line. If you come here, you can change the style of the writing also. Again, you can change the color whichever you like. You can make changes to the boundary line, increase or decrease the width of the boundary line. Again, try a different color of the boundary line and use the fill-in for the text itself. So this is how you have many variations of the font work available for you in the font work gallery. You can just click on the side, select it again by clicking on the text and then use the buttons to vary it. Now all of you use the font work gallery to write your school's name in the next slide. If you face a problem, watch the video and learn from it. With the help of this video, we will once again practice the use of the font work gallery to write, for instance, your school's name. So for that, we need to first take another blank slide in our Impress file. So we take a blank slide, but for taking the blank slide, we have to right click on the slide pane and then click on new slide. Then come to the font work option. Click there. The box opens showing many font work options available. So you can scroll up and down to see the type of style of font work or the title that you like to keep. So we can scroll up and down and then select the style that we like. As is being shown in the video, for the style that we like, we click on it and then we click on the OK button. You will see that the font work gets written on our slide in that particular style. Now, since you want to type some other text here as a title or the school name, click on this text which is already written here, and then you can use the delete or backspace button to delete this existing text like this. As is being shown in the video, we are deleting, and then we write, for instance, we will write computer shiksha, and after writing we click on the side and we will see that the title computer shiksha or the name computer shiksha appears in the font work style that we had chosen. Now if we click on it, it gets selected, and we can change the color of the fill-in. We can change, if we want to apply a gradient in the fill-in, we can select gradient and then change the color, or select the gradient that we like. We can change the color of the outline. We can change the width of the outline, and even we can apply a different style of the outline of our text. So right now we have done that. Next, if you select on this and you get these blue dots, if you click one more time you will get these red dots, and these are, you find circular arrows, and if you click the left button and keep it pressed and then drag it, you will see that you can rotate the title that you have written or the text that you have written. Once again, you can click on a different dot and get it back again. So this way you can change the style of writing, rotate it. If you click it once, you have the blue dots, and then with the arrows on it you can drag to increase or decrease the size. If you click twice, you get the red dots with which you can rotate the title. This is how you can use font work for writing your title. Let us now start learning about the view menu. As you know, you can use the options of the view menu to hide or show options on your impress page. Do you know what happens with normal, outline, slide sorter, handout page, and note page? Using these options, you can change the view of your slide. With these, you can see your slides in different views. And then, to change them back to their original view, you will use the normal option. Let us now watch the video and learn about each of these options one by one. With the help of this video, let us now understand the various options of the view menu. So, if you look at the view menu, click on the view menu in the menu bar, you will find many options. The first is normal. So this is the way the slide appears in the normal option. When you click on outline, you see the slides in your file only as an outline. The complete slide is not there. The next option in the view menu is the slide sorter option. Here you see your slides like you see them in the slide pane. The complete slide is not shown, but you can make out what is there in the slides. Next option is of notes page. If you click on this, you can write some notes which are required with the slide. So this is the notes page. Then the next is handout page. Here you see boxes available to you for the slides. The next, we just bring it back to normal by clicking on normal. So this is how you can use the various options of the view menu in your with your slides. The next option is for slideshow. Can you tell why we use slideshow? Using slideshow, you can watch your slides on the big screen. This will only show you the slide on which you have worked. The shortcut command for this is F5. To come out of the slideshow, you need to once press the escape button on your keyboard and your slide will then appear in the normal view. Let us now watch the video to understand the use of slideshow. Let us learn the use of slideshow option by watching this video. So with slideshow, you can get your slide that you are working on full screen in a large area. So to do that, go to the view menu and then click on slideshow. When you click on slideshow, you will see that your slide comes on a large screen. You can also do the slideshow or bring it on a large screen by using the shortcut command F5. Now if you want to see the other slides in your presentation, you can use the up arrow and down arrow keys to go to the next slide. So this is how you will use the slideshow option to see the slides in the large area. If you click to exit the presentation, or you can also use the escape key on the keyboard to come to normal view. The next option is of the sidebar. Do you know why we use the sidebar? The sidebar is on the right side of the Impress file and is also known as the slide layout. From here, you can hide or show sidebar. Let us watch the video and learn how to hide or show the sidebar. By watching this video, we will now see how we can hide or show the sidebar or the slide layout. To hide it, we take our pointer to the view menu, and if you see, the sidebar option is ticked already, so the sidebar is being shown. If you click on it once again, the sidebar gets disappeared. So this is how you can hide the sidebar. To bring it back again, we go back, take our pointer again to the view menu, click there, and then click on the sidebar option, and the sidebar or the slide layout will appear again. There is also a shortcut method. You see these dots here as is being shown in the video. If you click on this, it says hide, and if you click on this, the sidebar gets hidden. Then on the right extreme, you see the dots again. It says show. If you click on that, it gets shown again. So you can hide or show the sidebar from here also. The next option is that for slide pane. Do you know why we use the slide pane? The slide pane is on the left side of the Impress file. You can see all your slides in it. You can hide or show it from here. Let us watch the video and learn the usage of the slide pane. This video will help us to see how we can hide or show the slide pane. The slide pane is on the left side of your Impress file. In order to hide it, you need to take your pointer to the view menu in the menu bar, and then if you click on the slide pane which was on the left side of the impress file, it gets hidden. Again, if you want it to be brought back to show it again, you have to take your pointer to the view menu, as is being shown in the video, click on it, left click on it, and then left click on the slide pane option, and the slide pane appears again. You can also use the shortcut method to hide it by clicking on the buttons which are being shown here in the video, which says hide. When you click, it gets hidden, and then if you click on these buttons on the left extreme, it gets shown again. So this is how you can use slide pane. The next option is that of the toolbar. Do you know why we use the toolbar? The toolbar allows you to use many important tools like drawing, formatting bar, line and filling, etc. You can hide or show these from here. Using the toolbar, you can quickly get your work done. All of you have learned to use the toolbar in the writer modules. Let us watch the video and see how we make use of the toolbar. With the help of this video, we will now learn how we can hide or show the various toolbars that we use with our Impress file. So to hide or show the toolbars, we need to take our pointer to the view option of the menu bar, left click on that, and from the box that opens, click on the toolbars option, or bring your pointer to the toolbars option. You will see another box opens, and you can see that the toolbars which are already shown in your slides, in your file, shown as with a tick mark. Now if you click on the drawing toolbar will get hidden from your file. You can see the drawing toolbar is no longer in this file. Again click on view, bring your pointer to toolbars, and now click on the line and filling option. As soon as you click there, you will see that the line and filling toolbar also gets hidden. Again, take your pointer to the view menu and bring your pointer to toolbars. Now, click on the presentation option and you will see that the presentation toolbar gets hidden from our file. Once more, let's take our pointer to the view menu and bring it to the toolbars option. Now, if you click on standard toolbar or standard option, you will see that the standard toolbar also gets hidden. Now, to bring back these toolbars, you will again take your pointer to the view option in the menu bar. Click there, bring your pointer to toolbars, and now go and click on the standard option. As soon as you click there, you will see that the standard toolbar is shown again. Once again, go to the view menu, come to the toolbars option, and now let's click on the drawing option. Once you click there, you will see that the drawing toolbar gets shown again, as is being shown in the video to you. Again, let's take our pointer to the view menu, click there, select or bring our pointer to toolbars, and now let's look for line and filling option and click there. So you notice that the line and filling option is not being shown right now. In that case, just take your pointer to the corner here of the standard toolbar and just drag it up or down by holding the left button down and drag it up and down, and you will see that the line and filling toolbar appears. Next, again we take our pointer to the view menu, and bring a pointer to the toolbars option. Now we need to click on the presentation option. So we bring a pointer to presentation and click there. Once again, if you see that the presentation toolbar has not appeared, just take your pointer to the standard toolbar to the left extreme and drag it up and down, and your presentation toolbar also appears. You can drag the presentation toolbar to the right side of the standard toolbar as is shown in the video. So this is how you will hide or show various toolbars. The next option is of the status bar. Can you tell why we use the status bar? With the status bar, you can come to know how many total slides are there in your impress file. You also get to know how much you have zoomed on that slide. From the status bar, you can hide or show these options. Let us watch the video and learn how to hide or show these options. With the help of this video, let us learn how we can hide or show the status bar from our impress file. So first, to do this, bring your pointer to the view menu, left click on it, and then from the options, click on the status bar option. As soon as you click there, as is being shown in the video, you will see that the status bar gets hidden. It's no longer in your impress file. To bring it back or to show it again, we again need to take our pointer to the view menu, click there, and then again click on the status bar option. When you click on the status bar gets shown again on your impress file. The next option is that of the grid. Do you know what happens with the grid? With the use of grid, you can get lines on your slides which look like a graph paper. Let us watch the video and see how we can hide or show the grid. With the help of this video, we will now see how we can hide or show the grid on our impress file. So to bring the grid, we take our pointer to the view menu in the menu bar and then click on the grid option. From the grid option, click on display grid. So as soon as you click on display grid, you see these lines appearing on the top of your slide, horizontal and vertical lines. You can also show or hide the grid from the standard toolbar here, as is being shown in the video. Now once again, if we want to hide this, we go to the view menu and click on grid and click on display grid once again, and the grid gets hidden. So this is how you can use the grid on your slide. Next is the option of header and footer. Can you tell what happens with header and footer? As you have earlier learnt in the writer modules, with the header, you can insert a heading or a title top of your page. With the footer, you can insert page number or a summary at the bottom of your page. Similarly, on the impress also, with the header, you can put a heading, title, date and time, and with the footer, you can get slide number and any summary. However, you need to remember that in impress file, in the normal view, you will only be able to see the footer. To see the header, you will need to use the note view option. Let us watch the video and learn how we can use the header and footer. Let us now watch this video and see how the header and footer are applied to our slides in our impress file. So to apply the header or footer, we first need to take our pointer to the view menu of the menu bar, click on that with the left button, and then click on the header and footer option. When you click there, a box opens, as is being shown in the video. It has two options, slide and notes and handouts. Since we want to apply this on the slide, we click on the slide option. First option is the date and time. It's already pre-selected for the fixed option. If we don't want it, we can remove it. Or if we want to apply, we click on date and time. And if we click on variable, then there are options here which show the date in variable styles. So we can choose the one which we like. Then come to footer. As soon as we click on the footer option, you will see that in the preview slide here, you can see the footer is being shown. So in the footer, we can type some text. For instance, we are writing computer shiksha, as is being shown in the video. And then the next option is for slide number. So if you tick on this, a box in the footer on the right side opens, and that is for the slide number. If you click on the last option, which says do not show on the first slide, these header and footer will not be shown on the first or the title slide. So now if we say apply to all, you will see that this header and footer gets applied to the slides other than the title slide. You can see in the second slide, we can see the date and the computer shiksha and the slide number are written. So like this, you can apply your header and footer. If you go to view option again and click on header and footer and do not show on the first slide, now it will show on the first slide also. So since it is to make it visible, we go on to view again, click on header and footer, and click on do not and remove the tick from the do not show on first slide. Now let's see what happens in notes and handouts option. If you click on notes and handouts, there is an option for header. You can see that the header place has come, and we want to type as header just the word computer. Next, for date and time, again we take one of the variable styles of writing the date. Click on that. And then for the footer, if we tick it, a place for the footer appears. We can type a word here or a title here or a summary. So we are typing the word shiksha. Now, if we click on page number, you will see on the right side of the footer in the bottom, in the preview of the slide, it appears. Then we say click on apply to all and it shows. Right now you can't see it on the slide because we have applied it in the notes of the slide. So let's click on notes, and once you click there, you can see that the header, computer and the date is being shown here, and if you look at the bottom, the slide number is also being shown at the bottom. So this is how you will apply header and footer on your slides. Next comes the option of zoom. Do you know what happens with zoom? With the use of zoom, you can increase or decrease the size of your slide. Let us see the video and learn how to increase or decrease the size of the slide. Let us watch this video to see how we can zoom our slide or make our slide larger or smaller. To do this, in the status bar, we have on the right lowest corner, you can see it is showing 57% right now. and there is a minus and a plus sign with which you can also increase or decrease the zoom percentage. And a box opens, you can use that, or you can go to the view option, click on zoom, and the zoom box opens. In this, there are various options available: optimal, fit width and height to the available space, fit the width, or 100%. If we use 100%, click on that and press on OK, you can see the slide has become 100% zoomed up or larger in size. With the vertical scroll bar, you can see the slide's top and bottom portions. And with the horizontal scroll bar, you can scroll left and right to see the complete slide. Now, once again, if you click on view and click on it and then click on the zoom option, you will see the box again. And from this, if you select fit width and height option, then it will automatically fit the slide in the available height and the width. So when you press OK, you can see that the slide's height and the width have been fitted into the available area. So this is how you can use the zoom option to see your slides. Let us now begin to understand about the options of the insert menu. Why do we use the slide option from the insert menu? With slide, you can bring up a new slide. Now, all of you show how you will bring up a new slide by using the insert menu. If you have a doubt, then watch the video. This video helps us to use the insert option to bring up a new slide. The option of slide we use. So to use this, we take our pointer to the insert menu of the menu bar, left click on that, and then click on slide. So as soon as you click on slide, you will see that a new slide, a blank slide, gets inserted in your file. The next option is of the duplicate slide. Can you tell what happens with the duplicate slide? With the help of duplicate slide, you can copy any slide and get a slide same as the original one. Let us watch the video and learn how we create duplicate slides. With the help of this video, let us now see how we can bring up duplicate slide. So to bring up a duplicate slide, first, as is being shown in the video, let us select the slide for which we want the duplicate slide. So as is being shown here, we have selected the first slide. Now go to the insert menu and click on the duplicate slide option. You see that a duplicate slide is available to you. If you look here, there is start slideshow, hide slide and duplicate slide option in the slide also. So if you click here, this is a shortcut way of getting a duplicate slide. This is how you can duplicate your slides. The next option is that of page number. This is similar to the header and footer. By using this, you can insert a title or heading or date and time and slide number on your slide. Let us now watch the video and learn the use of page number. Let us now watch this video and see what happens with page number option. With page number also, we can use the header and footer. To use this, take your pointer to the insert option of the menu bar, click on page number, and a box will open. This is the same header and footer box. So again, if you go to the notes and handouts or the slide option, you can insert what you like. For instance, if you click on footer And since we have written computer Shiksha, if we click on slide number, a slide number space is there. And if you click do not show on first slide and insert variable date and say apply all, click on apply all, you will see that your date, the slide number and the title computer Shiksha has got applied to the slide. So this is how you can use page number also to insert header and footer. The next option is of date and time. This is similar to the header and footer. You use this to insert on your slide date and time or some heading or title. You can use this also in the same way as you use page number. Let us watch the video and learn to use date and time. The next option which is being shown in this video is for date and time, which also helps you in the same way to insert a header or footer or date and time. So take your pointer to insert and then after clicking there, click on the date and time option. You will see that the header and footer box opens again. Since already the date and time are available, you can just go ahead and click on apply all and you will see that the date and time gets inserted on our slides. This is how you use date and time. The next option is of fields. With fields option, you can insert date, time, author, etc. With the help of the video, all of you learn the usage of fields option. With the help of this video, let us now see how we can use the fields option. So let's select the fourth slide and let's see how we can use the fields option in this. To insert, go to the insert menu and from the options available, come to fields option. You see date, time, author, page number, file name. So if you click on date, a fixed date, you will see that a date gets inserted. You can drag this to this position as is being shown in the video. Once again, if we go to insert, come to the fields option, and this time let's select time, the fixed time, and it appears on your slide. You can drag it next to the date and leave it there. Again, go to insert option, come to fields, and now let's click on page number. So, since this is the fourth slide, you see that number 4 is written on this as page number. Move it wherever you want. Again, if we go to insert and now come to fields option, and this time let's select the file name or page count. First is page count. Since there are 5 slides, it gives us a page count of 5. Again, we can move it where we want. Once again, take your pointer to insert, come to fields, and this time click on file name. Since we have not saved the file, it is showing untitled 1, which is also the file name written in our title bar. If we had saved it, the same file name would have appeared. Today's class ends here. Now, all of you save your Impress file in a new location and then properly shut down your computer. In today's class, you learned about the options of the view menu like normal, outline, slideshow, handout page, note page, slide sidebar, slide pane, toolbar, grid, header, and footer and zoom. Then you also learned about font work gallery and about some of the options of the insert menu. Thank you.